How you doing? We want to welcome you this morning to Trinity Evangelical. I just want to give a heads up to the guys this morning that we'll be taking an offering. We will be doing it in the midst of worship. We're going to have a little short video towards the end of worship, and I'll kind of give you a heads up to come at that time, so just so you know what's happening. And while we're talking about worship, those of you who may be visiting us for the first time, we want to welcome you while we're talking about worship, while we're talking about offering. We want to welcome you and let you know that we're glad you're here. We're glad you're coming to check out God and what He's all about. And you're probably not familiar with the Trinity offering, so I just want to give you a heads up. When it's offering time, we want you to lean forward, tap the shoulder of the person in front of you, ask for their wallet or checkbook, and give the largest donation you've ever given to Trinity Evangelical. No, actually, I'm just kidding. If you're here visiting, Pastor Jim's not here either. I thought I'd get, he'd really like that. But anyway, if you're visiting, the offering time is really not for you. It's for the members and people that are very, supportive and come to this church all the time, and that's for them. We want this service to be a blessing to you if you're visiting. So part of that is let that plate pass right on by you. So as we begin our time, I did this last time, the Trinity fist bump. I mean, we still are just passing it around. I understand that urgent care at the hospital is about a two-hour wait, so in the hope that we don't spread anything else around, you don't have to shake hands this morning, but you certainly can if you want. So why don't you stand and greet those around you? Give them the fist bump if you want to, but say hello and greet everyone this morning.
We've gathered chain will break as broken hearts declare his praise. Who can stop the Lord Almighty? Our God is the Lion of Judah. He's roaring with power and fighting our battles, and every knee will bow before you. Our God is the Lamb that was slain for the sin of the world. His blood breaks the chain, and every knee will bow before the Lion and the Lamb. Oh, every knee will bow before the Lion. Make way before the King of Kings. Our God who calls the saved is here to set the captives free. Who can stop the Lord Almighty? Our God is the Lion of Judah. He's roaring and fighting our battles, and every knee will bow before you. Our God is the Lamb that was slain for the sin of the world. His blood breaks the chains, and every knee will bow before the Lion and the Lamb. Oh,
King above all kings.
King above all kings. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You lay down your life. That I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Son and daughter, the King of glory, the King of glory, who rules the nations with truth and justice, shines like the sun in all of its brilliance, the King of glory, the King above all kings. Oh, this is amazing grace.
powerful song. Why don't you go ahead and be seated? And ushers, if you want to come at this time, we're going to take the offering and we're going to watch just a short video while the offering is being taken.
The prophet Isaiah wrote, I am the Lord. Apart from me, there is no Savior. You are my witnesses, declares the Lord, that I am God. The rabbi walked wearily on the dusty path along the sea. It was dark already. He was on his way home. He was reciting that passage over and over in his mind. You are my witnesses, declares the Lord. In his concentration and the gathering darkness, he came to the fork in the trail and went right instead of left. He had never done that before. He found himself standing in front of the Roman fort just outside of town. Romans and Jews didn't get along well at that time. He had never even been there before. Suddenly, out of the darkness came the voice of the sentry. Who are you? What are you doing here? He shouted. Startled, the rabbi said, what did you say? Who are you? What are you doing here? Shouted the sentry again. This time, the rabbi's voice came back with much more confidence. What do you get paid for asking me these questions? He said. There was a long pause, and then the sentry responded, 3 denarii a week, Jew. Why? I'll give you double, said the rabbi. If you stand outside my house and ask me those 2 questions every morning when I leave home, who are you? And what are you doing here? Probably no questions are more fundamental to life than those 2. But one of the things Isaiah noted is that we who follow Jesus, are God's witnesses that He is the Lord. And so I pray today that for you and me, we would walk in such a way that what we say and what we do would say to the world, the Lord, He is God.
Powerful words. Let's declare it together. What we believe, it makes us who we are.
I believe. Eternal. I believe in the virgin birth. I believe in the saints' communion and in your holy church. I believe in the resurrection when Jesus comes again. For I believe in the name of Jesus. I believe in God. Holy Spirit, our God is 3 in 1. I believe in the resurrection, that we will rise again. For I believe in the name of Jesus. For I believe in the name of Jesus.
Our Father God, you are an awesome God. Father, we come to you today because we believe in the name of Jesus. Father, there is excitement in our hearts because we believe in the name of Jesus. Father, there is hope in our life because we believe in the name of Jesus. Father, we bring our prayer requests to you. Those in our life who need healing, those who need counseling, those who need to know your love because we believe in the name of Jesus. Father, we ask for your Spirit to fill us, that you would give us the boldness to go out and to proclaim to others about your love because we believe in the name of Jesus. So, Father, as we prepare to hear the message that you have prepared for us today, that you will deliver through Chad today, we come with hearts that are excited because we believe in the name of Jesus. And there's no other name. There's no other name in this universe by which we would rather live than the name of Jesus. And so, Father, it is in Jesus' name we come to you. Amen. Hey, welcome to Trinity Evangelical. Is this a great day to believe in Jesus? Let me hear amen. Oh, no. Let me hear amen. Oh, my gosh. You know, you can stand up anytime you want to in this church. You can raise your hands anytime you want to. You can clap anytime you want to. You can cheer anytime you want to. If I said OH, you would say, yeah, there wouldn't be any hesitation. But if I said JE, what would you say? I would hope you would say SUS. And I would hope you would get a little bit excited. We are excited to have you here today. If you are a guest with us today, we'd love you to take the bulletin, take that tear off part, fill it out. You can't drop any offering plate because I've already gone by. So take it out to the Welcome Center. We have a gift for you just for being here today. Also, if you have prayer requests, please write them down on that sheet. Get them to me. Turn them into the office. Bring them up and lay them on the kneeling rails later on so that we can join you in prayer for the things that are on your heart this week. Some quick ministry opportunities to share with you. There is a lot going on at that table as you walk out these doors to the left. As you come in the doors, it's on your right. But there are a lot of things going on there. They're selling dinner theater tickets. That's a fundraiser for our youth summer trip. If you don't know about the dinner theater, ask them. What a great time. You'll want to get your tickets early because it will sell out. Secondly, they have Rent-A-Kid forms there. The Rent-A-Kid is also a project that raises money for our kids' summer trip. All right? So if you got things around your house that need to be done that you can't do, they would love to come do them for you. Also, there are these really awesome T-shirts out there. Team Jesus. Team Jesus. You see, I don't have to go into how I would cheer if this was a Columbus Blue Jackets game or a Ohio State game or something. Well, guess what? My Jesus is more important than that. So this is also a fundraiser for our youth summer trip, but also it's a sermon series that we will begin on the last Sunday of March. So if you want to help prepare for that, you're welcome to get a T-shirt out there. Also, they're $15 for this kind, $18 for the longer sleeve ones. There's a lot of things going on. Kids Club is tonight also. Back in the Student Life Center, 6 to 7:30. So there are a lot of things going on. What we ask you to do is read your bulletin, check the featured ministry table out, and be involved. Be involved. All right, now this is it. This is the only transition you're getting, all right? So I'm going to do my best here because they already greeted each other, okay? So here we go, all right? It's my job to get you fired up for the service, all right? So this is what I want you to do. All right, if I say J-E, you say S-U-S, and then you say J-E, and I'll say S-U-S, and then this is what I want you to visualize. All right, I want you to visualize how you feel when your favorite football team is about to drive in for the winning touchdown. But then throw that out. I want you to visualize you're sitting, whether it's on TV or you had the money to buy the tickets, and you are there. And you are watching this stone in front of the tomb. And you're there when it rolls away. And the excitement that you're filled with, all right? So let's hear it. J-E.
S-U-S.
S-U-S. J-E.
S-U-S.
J-E. S-U-S. You've got to stand up and give the guy next to you a high five. Come on, let's go. Let's get fired up for Jesus. Do it right now. Let's go. All right.
I know. How's everybody doing this morning? Hey, do me a favor. Look at your neighbor and say, I'm so glad that you get to sit next to me. And And if they're not glad, that's their loss. Good morning, everyone. Glad that you guys are here. So glad that Pastor Jim honored me to bring the message this morning. With that, let's just bow our heads for a word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord Jesus, this morning we are praying for your Spirit to fill this room in a way that we've never experienced it. Lord, we ask that every word that is spoken here this morning will just sink into our hearts, would be a seed that is planted and that would just flourish into something so magnificent in honor of you. Lord, I pray that every word that I would speak this morning would not be my words, but would be your words, Jesus, speaking to the hearts of all of us. God, I'm so thankful for all that you've done, all that you will be doing. In your name we pray. Everyone said, amen. Well, we're starting a 3-week sermon series called Encounter. It's authentically worshiping a transparent God. And so we're going to be talking about this for the next 3 weeks. But speaking about worship, we have actually, the church and the SPRC and the members of the board, we have actually hired on a new staff person who will be joining us in the beginning of April as our worship director. His name is Bryce, and his wife's name is Kalia Mast. And so we are excited about them. So in a few weeks, you're going to be seeing some new faces around here. Man, just give them a high five. Don't freak them out or anything like that. Show them the love. But they're going to be here starting in the beginning of April. And that's going to be Bryce and Kalia Mass, the new worship directors with that. Well, this morning, as we start this message, Steve kind of like laid into it a little bit about going crazy. So I'm going to kind of just go off of that a little bit, Steve. How many of you guys have ever been to a sports event? Anyone? Now, how many of you guys have ever sat next to the crazy person? Anyone? Now, don't raise your hand if that's your spouse. Okay, or if that's who you brought. Or maybe you are the crazy person. I remember going to a few Ohio State games, and we went to one game, and the guy that was sitting in front of us had Brutus the Buckeye shaved into the back of his head, right? It was colored. I mean, it was like, it was fantastic. Been to different games where, you know, it's so cold outside, but you get those crazy guys who are wearing no shirts, right? And they try to spell something across all their chest. They're sitting there like, yeah, woo, we're crazy, right? The Nut, I think that's who it is at the Buckeyes game. He's at all of them, front row. He's painted. I mean, he is crazy at some of these things. You know, I've been to a few events where I dress up and I'm like, I'm all for it. I don't know about you, maybe I might be the only one here who's, if you watch a game on television, right, you're actually yelling at a TV. Think about it for a moment here. You're yelling at a television, you're screaming as loud, you're waking up your family at night, right, because they just scored a touchdown. You're going crazy, but you're the only one there. Right? You're yelling at a big screen and no one can hear you. We do some crazy things for sports. Now, there are some people that go to concerts, right? And you'll go to these, whatever concerts they are, and you'll see some of the girls that are just like bawling and crying, and they're like 500 feet away from their favorite artist, and they're like, oh my God, I just... right? And that's some of the guys at a football game, too. You know, they're going crazy. We get into this where we're all like, yes, man, I want to be that person, or I want to wear, I'm a fan of these guys. You know, and the question I had is, you know, why do we do this? Why do we dress up like this and go crazy and support our team and we get all into it? Well, as I was thinking about that, like, okay, well, we're fans, and we like the team, and we like to be a part of it. But there's a deeper issue to all of that. And I found out by just doing different things is that we do this because we are all worshipers. Everyone in here is a worshiper. We're human. We all worship something. We can't help it. It's who we are. It's what we are. It's what we do. It's how we were made. We were created to worship. Everybody in here worships. Now the question is what does the word worship mean to you? Here's my definition of worship. Worship is a response to what matters most in your life. Worship is a response to what matters most in your life. Maybe it is going to a game and going crazy. Maybe it's a car or a house or business or somebody, maybe whatever. But whatever's the most important thing in your life, our response to that is worship. Now, George Barna said this in a survey that he surveyed 1,000 of church-going Christians. And the question he asked was, have you ever experienced God through your worship or through a worship service? And only 1/3 said that they have ever regularly experienced God in church. Now, I could ask the same question of, hey, to the fans of a football team, have you ever experienced a game like that before in your life? Have you ever been so thrilled? And I can guarantee you probably more than 1/3 could say, wow, that was an amazing experience. But here's what I want to talk to you about today. And if you have your bulletin, inside of your bulletin is notes. And I want you to follow along with us as we go through this. And this is number one. Everybody worships something. But not every something should be worshiped. Let me tell you that again. Everybody worships something, but not every something should be worshiped. Paul says in Romans chapter 1, verse 25, he says this. He says, they traded the truth about God for a lie. So they worshiped and served the things God created instead of the Creator himself, who is worthy of eternal praise. Here's the key word, and I want to break this scripture down a little bit for you. The very first one, it says, they traded the truth about God for a lie. This indicated that they once worshiped God, but now they were like, hey, man, I worship God, but God wasn't what I wanted to worship anymore. So they traded that out for something totally different. They traded it out for a lie. They traded it for something that they thought was more important in their lives. The interesting thing about the word traded is that it means they couldn't really have both. Let me tell you something. I believe everybody in here worships. Everybody worships something. But the problem is that we can't really get into an authentic worship with our Heavenly Father because we have something in front of us that is stopping that worship. Because you can only worship one thing. We are either worshiping God or we're worshiping something else. And subconsciously, we might say, we might not even know we're worshiping something else in our lives, but we are so focused. Why? Because worship is the one thing that we enjoy the most, that we give a response to. It's the thing that we think about all the time. It's the thing we're like, man, you know, what is it? Because we can't worship both. You can't worship you know, whatever this is in your life, whatever this is, if it's, it could be your job, it could be, you know, whoever or whatever it is. You can't worship that and then turn around and worship God. You can't worship both of them. Why? Because worship is the thing that we value the absolute most in our lives. There can be nothing above this thing or equal to it. There is nothing higher and or more valuable in our life than that thing. And you have to figure out, what is that thing in your life? What is that thing that you worship the most? Is it God? Or is it something else? Let's go back to the scripture here. It says, so they worshiped, they traded the truth about God for a lie. So they had God, and they decided God wasn't good enough to worship anymore. So they traded to something else. So they worshiped and served the things. Not only did they just worship this thing, they also served this thing. And let me tell you about serving. Serving is an outward action to those things that we worship. So not only are they worshiping this thing in their life that's stopping them from worshiping our Father, but now they are serving this thing. It's an outward expression. Let me tell you something, that when you truly get into an authentic worship with God, not only are you just going to do it on the inside, but you are going to do it on the outside. Now, that could be anything. That however you, that's between you and God. But let me tell you, when you go to an Ohio State football game and you are a fanatic of this team and you are crazy for the Buckeyes or whoever it is, and they score a touchdown, you're not going to be like, yippee. You're not going to sit there and be like, man, that was cool. I like that. No, if you are a true fanatic, you're going to go crazy. You're going to start kicking things. You're going to go just go to someone you don't even know and give them a big old kiss. You might headbutt people, whatever it is. I'm not saying walk up to people in church you don't know and give them a big old kiss. But here's what I'm saying, is that you will go crazy for that. When was the last time you went crazy for Jesus? When was the last time that you got on Team Jesus and you went crazy for him because he did something in your life that you can't even explain anymore? When was the last time? Why are we having trouble with that? Because we have something here that is blocking us from our true worship with our Father in heaven. What are you worshiping in your life? What is this thing that we need to break down in our lives? There's this wall, and we might not know it, or you might sit here and go, yeah, I know exactly what that is, but there's no way that I can give that up. They served. Not only did they worship, but they also served. What are you worshiping? Second thing I want to talk to you about is not only does everybody, but we are made to worship. Look at your neighbor and say, we are made to worship. We are made to worship. In the book of Acts, Paul, he goes to, and this is Acts chapter 17, Paul goes to the city of Athens, and he enters the city, and he's proclaiming the gospel. And as he's walking around Athens, as he's sitting there, as he's walking around talking to the men and women, he kind of goes towards the middle, and he realizes that when he arrives into Athens, that this is the city of idols. It's a city full of idols. Everywhere he would go, there's an idol, a god, a deity. I mean, it's just full of it. And he walks around, and he can see it for everything. You know, there might be there's an idol for the sun. There's an idol for the stars. There's an idol for the ladybugs. Whatever it is, there's idols for everything in the city. There's the city full of idols. And as he's walking around, he realizes, he sees one idol that kind of really gets to his heart. And he looks at it, and in the inscription at the bottom of this, it says, to an unknown God. They got all the details and descriptions of all these other ones around. And it says this, that he gets up and he says this, it's an unknown God. Even with all the altars and all the idols that are around, these people wanted to make sure that they covered their bases, making sure that all the gods were happy. And so whatever they could not get out of these descriptions, it came under the category of an unknown God. And Paul walks up, he looks at this, and he says this. Says, he is the God who made the world and everything in it. Since he is the Lord of heavens and earth, he doesn't live in man-made temples, and human hands can't serve his needs, for he has no needs. He himself gives life and breath and everything, and he satisfies every need. Paul wanted the men and the women of Athens to know that he, Jesus, the unknown God, is the constant life-giving. He's everything. Why? Because we are made to worship. We are created. God is looking at you. He's seeking you. He's wanting you to be a part of that family, to be a part to worship him. Every time we see a sunset, every time we see the moon, every time it's a blessing, it's knowing God is still loving us. God is still pursuing us, even through all the hurts and everything. We are still made to worship. But it's hard to understand why, if we don't truly understand what worship is. You know, I have a lot of people will ask me, you know, Chad, man, we really, what do I need to for worship? Or, you know, man, it's not good. You know, I gotta work on my worship. It's hard to work on your worship when you don't know the true God. And it's hard to be able to not have authentic worship if you don't know that you are created for that. You know, we have like a young adult ministry here called Steadfast. Man, if there's young adults here that want to just have a time for themselves, man, we have that available. We have it for the children, the youth. We have places available for you to worship, but you've got to understand what worship is. Worship is this. True worship begins with Jesus. Period. There's no comma. It's a period. Worship, true, authentic, transparent worship begins with Jesus. When you don't know Jesus, it's hard to engage in worship. When you don't have that constant relationship with Jesus, it's hard to engage in worship. When you're not worshiping on a consistent basis and not just on Sundays, it's hard to engage in worship. When you're not starting with Jesus, then you're worshiping something else. Because it starts and ends with the man who died on that cross for you. That's what it starts with. One of the greatest needs of the church today is not new programs, new small groups, new ministries. That's not the need. The need for today, the need of the church today is to encounter God in a way that we've never encountered him before. The need of us as the people of this church is to desperately need a life-changing experience with God. To know his awesomeness, the wonder, the power, the mercy, the forgiveness, the love that Jesus has for us. That's what the church needs today. To have true worship. It's more than just singing songs. It's more than just you know, hey, Sunday morning for about 15 minutes, I'm going to worship God once a week. No, if that's what you think worship is, then I'm going to tell you something. I'm about to blow your mind. It's every single day of every single moment that we live is worshiping our Father in heaven. Because if we don't worship, He will lift up the rocks to worship instead. And I'm not going to be beaten by a rock. Let's worship Jesus together. Let's be able to do this as a congregation, as a church body, and say it doesn't matter what song is being played. Man, it's an outward experience. I'm going to outwardly show people that I am worshiping God, however that is in your life. Because if it's just inside, then man, it's nothing. It's got to be more than that. In Colossians chapter 1, verses 15 through 17, it says this: Jesus is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn over all creation. For in Him all things were created, things in heaven and on earth, visible and invisible, whether thrones or powers or rulers or authorities. All things have been created through Him and for Him. He is before all things, and in Him all things hold together. We are created to worship. Everybody worships. But before we can get to either one of those, it starts with Jesus. Today, I challenge you to not only just listen to the words that's been spoken this morning, but when you walk out these doors, do not be the same person you were when you walked in. Be someone who wants to authentically worship a transparent God. Not just, hey, I'm going to listen to some music, that would be great. No. It's more than that. It's your lifestyle. It's everything we do. I'm not saying you can't watch football anymore and be like, oh, great. God, Chad convicted me. I can never watch football because I feel like I'm worshiping. I'm not saying that. What I am saying is, what are you worshiping and why? Because my prayer is that not only do I worship God, but I pray that Thy will be done. Pray that His will would be done in my life. Thy will be done. That is my prayer. Praying that God, have Your will done in my life. Let it be more than just about me. Lord, let it be more than just the words I speak. But let my actions show. God, I truly, authentically want to worship You with everything that I have. Let's bow our heads for a word of prayer. Jesus, I pray this morning that we would get out of the mindset of what we think worship is. And we would turn our mindset, we would change our mind and know what worship truly is. It's the most important thing in our lives. And I pray that everybody in here, Jesus, You would be the most important thing in their lives. Praying that Thy will be done in our lives, Jesus. You created us. Guide us now. And let us have wisdom and understanding of where You want us to go. Even through our hurts and our pains, and we might not feel like we're on the right track with You, God, but Lord, let us just settle down. Pray for peace. Say, God, today, even through the storm that I'm going through, I'm going to worship You. I'm going to do everything that will honor and glorify You. I am going to worship You.
So I follow through, and somehow I ended up here. I don't want to think, I may never understand, that my broken heart is a part of your plan. When I try to pray, all I've got is hurt and these four words: Thy will be done, Thy will be done, Thy will be done. And I know you're good. Distracted by the noise, I'm just trying to make sense of all your promises. Sometimes I've got to stop and remember you are God, and I am not. So Thy will be done, Thy will be done, Thy will be done, like a child on my knees. To me is Thy will be done, Thy will be done, Thy will. I know you see me, I know you hear me, Lord. Your plans are for me, goodness you have in store. And I know
this morning, let that be our prayer. Thy will be done. And when we walk out of here today, let's be worshipers. You might say, well, how do I do it on the outward? Man, we got a Team Jesus shirt out there. Go buy 5 of them, keep one for you, and go give them to 4 other people and wear them every single day. Let people know however you want. But let's be truly authentic worshipers to a transparent God. Amen. Have a great day. Praying for you, and we'll see you next week.